Hello everyone, and welcome to this video. Let's see how you can quickly and easily learn how to use Adobe After Effects CC Release 2017 when starting for the first time. Please leave us any comments below in the video description to improve our future video guides. After Effects is one of the most complete and professional video editing software, mainly used in post-production. This is different from Premiere Pro CC. It is used to add effects, particles, and transitions in order to enhance the overall video appearance. When you open After Effects, a dialog box opens. This is used to create a new or to open existing projects. Under Recent, you can find all your most recent After Effects projects ready to use. Below this, you will use New Project to start with a new project, or use Open Project to browse for an existing one. You also have the possibility to work with team projects, which are special projects that can be shared inside groups and teams. We won't see these in this very basic tutorial. In order to see and learn all the basic features you need inside After Effects, let's create a new project. The overall project interface is composed of several panels, and they change slightly depending on the workspace chosen at the very top. For simplicity, we will see just the default one called Essentials. Each of these panels you see can be closed and eventually reopened by going to the Windows tab and choosing them from the list. The first thing to do with a new project is to import all the media files you need, which can be either images, videos, or sound files. You can do so by simply dragging and dropping them on the project from your computer. Hold the Control button down and select multiple files if you want to import more of them at once. All of these files imported, called footage, are listed with their name, format, and size under the project panel on the left. Just remember that all these files are imported as simple links. This means that if the original file is either deleted or moved elsewhere, it won't be available in this project anymore, and it will be shown in italics. In case you simply move it elsewhere, just right-click on the file and go to Replace Footage, and then to File to relink it to the new location. Once your files are inside the project panel, just drag and drop them on the timeline panel at the very bottom. These will be contained inside rows called layers, represented as colored rectangles with a fixed duration. When the first clip is imported, you will also create a new composition that collects all the layer rows you see. This will also be listed inside the project panel with the frame icon on the left. So you can see that this panel shows you the overall content of your project, composed by a single or multiple compositions. And each composition is indeed a collection of layers listed and placed on the timeline, containing images, videos, audio files, or even other compositions that you can import inside the timeline and seen as footage. To create new compositions, click on the frame icon at the bottom of the project panel. Each composition has its own settings that you can check and edit by right-clicking on its name and going to Composition Settings. Here, you can set the composition name, its video resolution, and also its frame rate. Also, under Duration, you can extend the overall duration of the composition. This is important in case there is an insufficient duration that contains all your media. Let's see how to preview your project inside After Effects. On the central part of the interface, you have the main video preview used to check how your project is going. In particular, if you double-click on any footage inside the project panel, this will be opened in the video preview. You can also double-click on a layer inside your timeline to preview it. In order to check the overall content inside the composition that is open on your timeline, just double-click on it from the project panel. Also, use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Hold the spacebar key and click, and drag to pan and check the details. You can play and stop quickly by using the spacebar key. The first preview may not be excellent. After Effects needs to render the preview first until the thin green line you see covers the whole timeline duration. At this point, the preview will be fluid. Pay attention to the video preview timeline. This always refers to the element you have chosen that you can check on the tab above. For example, if you have a layer or a footage open, the timeline will follow the duration. But if you open a composition, you will directly preview all its content that is shown in the main timeline below. In this case, the video preview shows exactly what is under the blue playhead. You can also click and drag it to check an exact frame. Now, let's see how to edit your composition through the main timeline. You can zoom in and out by holding down Alt and using your mouse wheel on it. To move each clip in time, just click and drag it to where you like. Consider that you may need to wait for the composition to be rendered again to get a good preview. You can also stretch or shorten a clip by clicking and dragging from its furthest most edges. There's no problem for image clips, but for video and audio clips that have a fixed duration, you may not be able to stretch those over it. Also, if you shorten them, After Effects shows the cut content under a darker color. You can also use the video preview to correct the appearance of the visible clips. If you have a composition open, you can select each of its clips from the timeline to edit their position by clicking and dragging. You can also scale in size by using the nodes you see. You can rotate each clip selected by enabling the rotation tool on the left and clicking and dragging on the video preview. Let's see how to fully edit each of your layer rows inside your timeline. All the tools and settings of those are collected on the left. First of all, each layer gets the name from its footage imported by default, but you can rename it by right-clicking on it and going to Rename. Also, the layer order sets the order of visibility of the view preview. In short, a layer that is placed on top is shown above all the other layers that stay below. To change a layer position, just click and drag it up or down from its name. You can cut, copy, and paste the layer by selecting it and going to the Edit tab above. In case you make any mistake, you can undo your latest action by using Ctrl and Z with your keyboard. On the far left of each layer, you have four important buttons to control the content inside the composition. Inside visible layers, such as videos and images, you can use the eye icon to hide or show their content. Inside videos and sound files, you can use the speaker icon to mute or unmute these. For all layers, you can use the solo icon to play back just the specific layer, or use the lock icon to block any possible change or modification on the layer content. Each layer has a small gray arrow. If you click on it, you will check the full list of properties and features for each layer. For example, image layers show the transform section used to adjust the layer content position, size, inclination, and transparency through opacity. To change these settings, you can either click on a value to type it directly, or simply click and drag it to fine-tune the settings. Use reset to return to the original values. To check the effect of your modifications, make sure to have the video preview open on the composition with the blue playhead placed over the layer you wish to preview. Layers with an audio content have the audio section that shows the volume level under audio levels and the sound waveform under waveform. Videos that have audio inside show both transform and audio sections. Inside this list are included all the effects applied to each layer. You can apply amazing effects by going to the Effects and Presets panel on the right and browsing for your favorite effect. Then, just drag and drop the effect on the layer. This will be added inside the list with all its settings. You can also enable and disable each effect by clicking on the FX icon on the far left in order to see how the layer changes with the effect applied. Let's see how to add a simple title. To do this, just enable the horizontal type tool on top and click and drag on the video preview to create a text box that is used to contain your text. After that, type in and modify all the text properties by using the character panel on the right. To place text correctly, just click and drag it directly on the video preview. Remember that text is no more but an independent layer inside your composition. Let's see how to save and render your project. To save your overall project, including all the settings and effects applied on each single layer and composition, go to File, and then to Save As twice. If you want to obtain the final video to upload it online or simply play it back, you have to render it first. The Render Cube panel is used to render your selected compositions individually from top to bottom. You can open it by using the Window tab. At this point, open the composition to render, go to the Composition tab, and then to Add to Render Cue. This will show up on the Render Cue panel under Render Settings. Click on Best Settings to adjust the quality, resolution, and frame rate on the right. Keep in mind that the size is determined by the composition settings seen before. Under Output Module, click on Lossless to select the video format to use, the color code, and the main audio settings. Click on Output 2 to set the destination folder, which is where the final video will be saved, and the name for your video. Once the destination folder is set, the new status will be queued, and then you can start rendering by going to Render on the far right. The part of the composition that will be rendered is just the part that is within the work area on the timeline, which is the second thicker bar from the top. You can stretch and move it as you like by clicking and dragging on it. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more professional and free Adobe tutorials.